Brethren, she's not picking no.
Brother John, how did you propose?
Yes, I... We were talking. And I asked her what kind of man she wanted, and she said some things, actually.
What did you say?
I've forgotten. But later on, she asked me what kind of woman I want.
Very good. Now, what did you tell her?
I said you.
Excuse me. I don't understand.
I said you. That's what I said. I said you.
You did what?
That was what I said. You.
Brother John, why are you doing like this? You didn't get on one knee. You didn't get her flowers. You didn't get her anything. You just went and proposed and expecting a reply.
No. God in his mercy took time to create some people without emotions.
Brother John. Man,
I didn't just say you. Yeah, I didn't just say you.
Oh, okay.
I said something else.
Very good. Now, what was that thing you said?
Yeah, I said you. I want to marry.
Sorry. Who are you commanding?
You want to marry, Brother John? That is worse. That is worse, sir.
You don't talk like
worse.
That.
That is worse. May I ask, where was the location of this proposal?
Yeah, in the classroom.
Jesus is Lord.
No.
Jesus is Lord. No. No. Brother John, classroom. Brother John, you have broken the edge.
Classroom?
The foundation of this proposal is destroyed.
What can the righteous do?
What are we going to do?
We? I don't like your pronoun. Brother John, you need to work on your pronoun.
Pronoun is very insulting.
Brother John.
First of all, you insulted an innocent sister by telling her, you, I want to marry.
Who does that?
I don't know. Now it is we.
We.
Hello, mine. How are you?
John, are you okay?
Yes, I'm okay.
Baby, I've been calling you since morning and you've not picked up. Why?
I'm sorry. I was having my morning devotion.
It's 1 p.m.
1 p.m.? Oh, I've been praying since 6 a.m. I'm sorry.
What are you even praying about?
Our ministry. The assignment the Lord gave to us. You know Caleb in the Bible. He claimed the mountain when he was very old. I don't want to wait until I'm old before I claim this mountain. I want the mountain now. This mountain is mine. It's mine.
Okay, I'll be praying for you.
Oh, thank you. What are you doing?
I'm watching my favorite Telemundo TV series, Red Roses. Do you know that Roberto and Juliana are finally getting married?
Oh, that's great. Wonderful. Hope they have gone to the marriage committee for further counseling.
What?
Yes, so advise them to do that. Because that is the only condition they are going to allow them to conduct their wedding in this church.
I'm confused.
What is the problem?
Roberto and Juliana, they are the central characters of the TV series. What do you think they were?
I thought they were members of our church.
John, you promised me you would watch this now. How many episodes have you watched?
Sister Debbie, to be honest with you, I've been quite busy.
So busy that you don't have time to honor my request. It's so sad. A whole season passed and you couldn't even watch one episode. The most annoying part is that you're going to miss the wedding of Roberto and Juliana.
Debbie, okay, when you see them, help me apologize to them. The fact is, there are more important things to deal with.
So I'm not important?
You are.
Roberto is not important.
Debbie.
Juliana is not important.
Everyone is important to the Lord.
You think I'm childish. You think I'm disturbing you. If you can't honor simple requests like this, how will you honor the main ones when we get married?
Debbie, remember we have assignments. Remember we have commitment. We both decided we are going to read the Bible from back to back this year. Of which I'm lagging behind. Even the vision for the teenage girls has been dormant. And you have an important part to play. If all these assignments are not executed, there's no way I will have time to attend the wedding of Brother Roberto and Sister Juliana. Eh?
It's okay. Those things are much more important than these childish movies I'm forcing you to watch. It's obvious you pay little or no priority to the things we share together.
Debbie, don't talk like that.
I think I need to find my place and stick there.
Your place is right here with me.
Then why do you keep talking like I'm carnally minded, like I'm a non-believer?
Debbie, I have never implied that.
I need to understand that the lives of Roberto and Juliana is much more than a story. It's something I need us to key into. Their journey signifies hope in God and faith in love.
Okay. Debbie, I promise I'm going to watch that movie with you at a much later time.
It's okay, John. I forgive you.
Ah, thank you very much. You know what, Debbie? As I was praying this morning, the Holy Spirit impressed on my heart some wonderful prayer points.
I'm listening.
That we need to pray about. So you know what you do for me? Take your Bible and your diary and write this prayer point. It's very important we pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, I break into my breakthroughs. I storm into my progress. Hey, I shall arise.
Are we getting ready?
Oh, yes, we are.
I'm not just talking about the family introduction.
So what are you talking about?
I'm talking about life after the wedding. Do we have enough to sustain us?
We have more than enough.
Really?
We have God.
Take God away from the equation.
God is the central part of this equation. We can't remove him. He's the foundation with which we are laying this marriage upon.
There we go again.
What?
Talking to me like I'm a non-believer.
You are not a non-believer.
Then let's communicate on the same frequency.
Which other frequency have we been communicating?
Maybe the problem is with me.
Why are you always like this? Any little talk, you get emotional.
Maybe my salvation isn't based on the same foundation you laid yours on. I think I need to work on my foundation as a Christian.
Okay, Debbie, you know, I was wrong. I admit, I was too judgmental. Please forgive me.
It's okay. You're forgiven.
So, Debbie, please, I want to understand your own point of view. What do you mean we are not ready?
What is holding you? Can't hold both of us.
The vision is enough for both of us.
Leave the vision aside and let's face reality.
The vision is my reality.
Look at this place.
Yeah?
Where are we?
We're in church.
What are we doing here?
What did they do in church?
Maybe you should consider dividing the place. We can use the pulpit as the bedroom, the backstage as the kitchen, and the hall for the living room.
Of course, see, why are you talking like this, Debbie? I told you I'm planning on getting a house.
Getting a house is a reality. Getting a sustainable pay is a reality. So how realistic is your vision?
How do you want me to answer this question?
What is your monthly take-home pay?
50,000 naira.
50,000 naira is not enough to sustain a family.
It's just for now, Debbie. Don't you believe God can upgrade me? Aside the fact, you will also work to, by the time we pull resources together, it will take us far.
I'm not ready to go far with what you're driving with.
But are you ready to go far with what is driving me?
If it can drive us both comfortably, I'm fine with it.
Okay. I'm actually working on getting a better job. They will call me next week for an interview.
How much is the pay?
150,000 naira.
Why didn't you tell me?
I wanted to make it a surprise.
My dear, I'm going to pray about this. The job is yours.
My fiancé broke up with me.
Oh, sorry, sir. I'm sorry. That must be a very painful thing, sir.
Sorry. No, that's not you. Actually, that's not you. Okay. It's not beyond what God can handle. As in, there are other things to deal with than to waste my tear on a sister. My Redeemer lives. God does not forsake me. He still loves me. God loves me. I know. But I know. I will not waste a single tear on a sister. No, I won't.
Oh Lord, why have thou forsaken me? Why have thou forsaken me?
Please.
I can't take this anymore. This is too much. much. What have I done? Eh?
What? Why are you crying? Talk to me. Why are you crying? Huh? I have never seen Brother John cry like this before.
But I like what I'm saying. I like what I'm saying.
What? You like what you're saying? Like,
yes.
This guy's crying. Come on.
Anything that will make Brother John cry must be the passion for souls, the zeal for God's kingdom, and the state of the church. Brother John, hit us with the revelation. We want to share your tears.
Sister Debbie dumped me. Sister Debbie dumped me.
I don't understand.
I've been cutting for 2 years. She dumped me this morning. She called it quits. Friends. Oh, I'm in pain.
It's well, Brother John. It's well, my brother.
We had dreams. We had visions. We had commitments. But she threw everything to the trash. She walked out on me.
But Bro John, eh? The Lord is your strength. This is well.
But John, you have to be strong.
You have to move on.
Eh? Where am I moving to? Eh? Where? After 2 years.
You just have
years.
To be strong. See, do you know how many times I heard no when I was single? Many sisters said no to me. I heard no to the point that sisters in the church started calling me Brother Noah.
Did you hear that? Did you hear his testimony?
Is that a testimony?